Hello guys, we are on chapter 4 of Project Management TYBMS and the chapter name is Project Manager. Okay. Okay, so as we are studying about project management as a whole, we obviously need to know what exactly does a project manager does, okay? And there is a lot of scope in this career as well to become a project manager, okay? So the very first part that you need to know is what exactly does a project manager do in your project management. Okay. So the very first part, if you see in a project management, you are having your execution, okay, which you need to done. But why and how are you going to do the execution first? You plan, you initiate, then you evaluate everything, then you see if it is validated, and then you execute everything. Okay. So there are certain roles of a project manager that you need to follow, okay? The very first one is he need to make strategies to make his project work in the market, okay? Or else he also needs to make a strategy that how exactly will he make this project a successful one by a given period of time. Okay. The second one is teamwork, very very important. Okay, he needs to see that all his team, workers in a team are coming together and working together, and if there is any conflict, he is there to solve it. Then you have the quality of material that has been used, the quality of human resources, okay, their education, their skills, their talent. He also needs to plan certain things. We all know that without planning, nothing takes place. And then he also needs to monitor. Monitor means to keep an eye over the project, the human resources, and also the funds are. Okay, so these are the roles that he need to take care. Then there are certain selection criteria for project manager. Like how exactly do you select the project manager? Randomly, aise kisi ko utha nahi sakte, right? So the very first one is he should have a good communication. We all know that. Okay. Then you have the integrity. Integrity means the honesty. Okay, how honest he is with his work. Enthu hona chahiye. Okay, he should be energetic all the time, because if he is not energetic, his laborers won't be energetic. Okay. Then you have competency. Delegate task. He should do his task and responsibility very well. Okay. And then you have, he should be cool under pressure. Very very important. We have seen Dhoni leading the Indian team when he is all cool and calm, and we know what were and what are the results. Okay. The last part of this chapter, chapters are very small here. The last part is the role of consultant manager. Okay, what exactly does a consultant manager do? Consultant manager tells you, he assists you with his own knowledge that which project are you supposed to pick up, and how much well will you do in that project depending upon your capacity. Okay, so this consultant helps you to take the business decision. He won't tell you the exact decision, but he will help you. Like say for example, normal example, you are very confused to pick up dresses, okay, and you're confused between two dresses. Okay, if you ask your mother her opinion, she might tell you which she like, what are the pros and cons of the dresses, but ultimately you are the one who's going to pick up your dress. So just like how your mother or your friend is helping you to make a decision, in the same way a consultant helps you to make a decision for your business. Okay, I hope this chapter is clear. It was very small and very easy. The next chapter that we have is the fifth chapter, that is the last chapter of unit 1, that is your module 1. Okay, so coming to the fifth chapter, which is project planning. Here we are going to talk about how exactly do you do your project planning, okay? But first we need to understand what is project planning. Okay, project planning is a part of project management which relates to the use of schedules such as Gantt charts to plan and subsequently report progress within the project environment. Okay, we want to see what exactly is Gantt chart. Project planning can be done manually or by the use of project management software. So project management, project planning can be done normally, okay, taking help of your fellow colleagues, okay, but also there are certain softwares that help you to record everything that you have done. Okay, I'm very sure that in your semester 6 you would have learned what is exactly EDI or MRP in logistics. Okay, so these are software that help you to lower your work. Then you have the functions of project planning. Again, an important answer. The very first one is integration management. Integration again has come from the logistics part. Integration means together, combining all the factors and all the functions. Okay, how do you combine all the functions and do the management? The second one is scope management. Okay, why and how will you inculcate scope if you pick up this particular project? Okay, then you have stakeholder management. I hope you all know what are stakeholders. Stakeholders are the customers, the government, the suppliers, the employees, government. Okay, so all these people come under stakeholder. You need to manage them really very well. Then you have time management. As I said, project management ka ek start time hota hai aur ek end time hota hai. So you need to manage that. Cost management, very important. Quality management, as I said, what kind of quality are you using? Okay, the material that you are using. And then you have your HRM, that is your human resource management. Appointing, recruiting, selecting, handling the conflict, everything. Okay? Then you have again an important concept, which is the project management cycle. How exactly does the project management cycle take place? The very first one is initiating process. Okay, someone has to initiate the project, without that nothing is going to happen. Then after initiating, first taking the first step, a baby step, then you start planning everything. Okay, let's take example of you going to Goa with your friends. Obviously that never happens, okay, but still being very positive. First, one of you just come up, ki chalo kidhar ghumne jaate hain, and you say, let's go to Goa. Then you start planning. Planning mein kya kya aayega, chalo, hum kaise jayenge, kitna budget hai, wahan pe jaake kidhar khana hai, ka rehna hai, everything. What adventure you want to do, that is planning. Then you do the execution, then you start searching maybe on Make My Trip, that or maybe you are thinking of taking up a Zoom car. You will start searching, you will start executing it. Then you monitor it. Okay, monitor it means you see, chalo, actually plan ban raha hai, sahi se ban raha hai ya nahi. Agar koi khane ka dekh raha hai, toh main traveling ka dekhunga. And the last part is the closing process. So you ultimately go and reach Goa, that is to be your closing process. Okay, same thing happens with your project. Initial, planning, executing, monitoring and closing. Closing is like the wind up, you are done with your project. Okay? Then you have a small concept which is known as the project conflict. There are a lot of human ideas that clash with each other. Okay, the more people around you, the more ideas you get. The more ideas you get, you might or may not agree to it. Okay, so project conflicts basically happens because there is a lack of communication. People are not very familiar with each other. They do not want to work, maybe because of the personal reason or XYZ, whatever. Groups achhe nahi bane hai. Okay, I am very sure this might have happened with you all also. When you have presentations, okay, in your class for a subject, if the teacher gives you the group and if you are not happy, conflict starts happening. If you make your own group, it's a very different thing. Okay, so project conflicts happen because either you have personal issues with each other or you have maybe interrelated issues with each other. Okay, fine, my best friend is having a conflict with him, indirectly even I have conflict with him. Brands, business, entrepreneurs ke beech mein bhi ye hota hai. Okay, then you have the types of project conflict. As I said, the very first one is the manpower resource. Okay, second is the cost. The quotation is not up to the mark, you cannot pay so much, you cannot do so much. Scheduling, responsibilities, usko kam responsibility diya, mujhe zyada diya. Why? Conflict. Okay, then you have personal clashes, everyone have that. And then you have capital expenditure. Mujhe paisa mil raha hai 10 lakhs, main spend kar raha hu 20 lakhs, baki ka 10 lakhs mere pocket mein se ja raha hai, wo company mujhe nahi dega. Kyun? Something like that. Okay, then you have your planning cycle. We had project cycle, now we have the planning cycle. Planning cycle is basically including four steps, okay, where you have again the same thing: initiation, planning, execution and close. Okay. The next part that we have, that is the last part of your unit 1 chapter 5, is master production schedule. Very important. Okay. Have you gone to malls? I'm sure you all have gone. Okay. When you go to the washrooms, na washroom ke door ke piche bada sa master schedule hota hai. Okay, like there are lines, there are employees' name, wash basin, washroom, cleaning, drying, everything has been written. Okay, that is known as a master production schedule. पूरे मंथ का उधर ऑलरेडी शेड्यूल करके रखा होता है, लाइक व्हाट अबाउट द स्टाफिंग, द प्रोडक्शन, द इन्वेंट्री, द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, द छोटा मोटा खर्चा खाने का दैट यू गिव टू योर एम्प्लॉयज, द वेयर एंड टेयर ऑफ योर मशीन्स एज वेल, ओके, द रेंट, एवरीथिंग इज इंक्लूडेड इन योर MPS, दैट इज योर मास्टर प्रोडक्शन शेड्यूल. ओके, आई होप दिस विल फाइन. ओके, obviously if there is any doubt you have the comment section to put on. So with this we are done with your unit 1 chapter 5. In your unit 1 there are 5 chapters. These are very small one, easy one, but an important one. Okay, thank you. I will be seeing you guys in the next unit.